I would like to revisit a little bit the complexity discussion of the Ford-Fulkerson algorithm. We have seen before that the total time complexity was order of the value of the maximum flow times the number of edge. This is a little bit strange to have the time complexity that is expressed in terms of the final results. So we would like to get rid of this time complexity that is expressed in terms of the final value of the flow. So instead, we will use U as the maximum capacity of the graph on any edge. And so we can express the time complexity here. We know that the cut of that partition between S and T, which is the rest of V minus S here, is at most this, right? That's the max flow min cut theorem. We know that the capacity of that cut is at most this. And so the time complexity can be re-expressed as V times E times U, which is the maximum capacity on any edge in the graph. So is this polynomial? No, it's still not polynomial because it depends here on this value, which may not be polynomial, which is the absolute value on any edge. So now the goal is to improve the Ford-Fulkerson time complexity. It's a very generic idea that you can reuse in different contexts, which is the idea of scaling. What we will do is that we will only consider first very big augmenting paths, very, very large ones. We will not be interested with augmenting paths that are very small. And so we will put a threshold that is delta here, capital delta, and we will only consider in the residual graph edges that have residual capacity at least, which are at least delta. The one that are less than delta will simply be filtered out. Then we find an augmenting path on this graph where you have filtered all the edges with residual capacity smaller than delta. And once it's not possible to find an augmenting path in this graph, then we will consider decreasing delta and we will divide it by two. So we start with a very large value for delta, for instance, 2 to the power log of u. And so we know that there will be at most this amount of downscaling phase for the value of delta until we reach 1. The question now is how many augmenting paths can we discover at most in one delta scaling phase? Okay, so at iteration I, you've got the value delta. At iteration I plus 1, you will use delta divided by 2. Okay, how many augmenting paths can you have in each step? That's the question that we need to answer. Once we have that, we just need to multiply this by the number of augmenting paths and then we multiply again by the time complexity of the depth first search, sorry, to find one augmenting path. So let's answer that question of the number of augmenting paths that we may be able to discover at one iteration. We consider the flow f at the end of the delta scaling phase, and this is the value of the flow. These are the set of nodes reachable from the source node in the residual graph with the delta edges that have been removed. We know by the max flow min cut theorem that this is an ST cut, right? By definition. And the residual capacity of that cut is at most the number of edges times delta. Okay, we know that because we have removed all the edges that are less than delta. So if F is the optimal flow that we need to reach, then the gap at that step, the gap between the two, is at most this. And so in the next scaling phase, we know that we will at least carry delta divided by 2 units of flow for each augmenting path. And this is the upper bound. So you can divide the upper bound by the least increasing value of every augmenting path. You've got this. And this is an upper bound on the number of iterations that you need to perform at every step in the delta scaling phase. So we just need to multiply everything. We've got this amount of delta scaling phase. And this is the utmost number of augmenting paths that we will discover in every scaling phase. And to discover one augmenting path, that's the cost of the DFS. Once you multiply everything, you've got this. And this is polynomial. Okay, this is strongly polynomial in the input size, because you take the log of the maximum capacity of every edge.